With rants and raves, you'll be okay. And today is your lucky day. It is Rants and Raves with Gary K.
Hey everyone, this is Gary K, and I am joined with Melody Craigmyle. Melody, of course, is with Almo Pro AV. Melody, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Gary. Thanks for having me on the show.
Well, let's get right down to it. The reason why I wanted you to be on my show is to talk about the E4v. You know, everyone's gone virtual, but there's a big difference between the E4v, your virtual E4 experience show now called E4 Evolution, and all the other ones that are out there. And we've helped kind of make that special. Let's get the bad out of the way. Everyone's tired of virtual events. So having a talking head just give you a webinar is just not that interesting anymore. So you've done a lot of work to make it different.
Yeah, we certainly have. And when we went into this project, we knew we wanted to be different than anything else out there. Of course, our first one was in April, and it was pretty ambitious, but we've learned a lot in the past year. We've listened a lot to our customers and attendees and really tried to hone in on those things that are really important. And, you know, we are rooted in our education. That's what the E4 has always been about, is about free, high quality education to the industry. But I think one of the most important things about virtual events is the user interface. And I think that's where a lot of these shows have lost focus.
Yeah, let's be honest here. Most of the shows aren't really shows. They like use webinar platforms, and then they just deliver content like you're on Zoom or on WebEx or something like that. And those platforms are awesome for webinars, but they're not awesome for longer term events where you're going to have multiple speakers or you're going to have multiple topics. In fact, I do your webinars, and we have phenomenal attendance. But they're always a beginning and middle and end in a short period of time. And it's specifically to deliver educational information or product information. But in this case, what you're trying to do is recreate, what you're trying to really do is not just deliver education. You're trying to recreate a personal experience at an event that creates a level of engagement. Like you meet someone you haven't met before, you talk to someone that you feel like can give you information. That's what you've been able to recreate with the E4 Evolution.
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, sort of like at a live show, and we're certainly not trying to recreate the atmosphere of a live show, but, you know, there's areas of entrance like the audio pavilion, you know, and that's kind of what gave me the idea of like, let's have halls specifically for digital signage or distance learning or next gen workspaces. So when someone comes into the show, they can immediately go into an area where all of that content about that particular vertical or topic is curated for them. So they're not clicking around in virtual booths and trying to find what they're looking for or watching stuff that's already out on manufacturers' websites. I mean, we really have it down to areas of interest with brand new, fresh, curated content.
Yeah, that's another key factor too, is none of the content has been seen before. So it's brand new content. And in fact, that's one of the big things that you push us when we partnered on this, was that you always wanted to have new content. You didn't want to do the same things you were doing in the webinars, because that is this kind of a separate engine that kind of runs itself. You want people to come to the E4 Evolution and be surprised by not just new education, but also the product information. That's a part of a differentiator too, is that you don't have virtual booths. What you have is product application and solution center areas where you can go through, as you mentioned, and figure out your area of interest. So if you're interested in, for example, UCC, you have a place to go as opposed to wandering around trying to find the UCC products where display products are. And that's a big differentiator. The other thing is, as everyone may know by now, you're using the LAVNCH platform. And one advantage of that is you're going to have some really cool networking functionality where people can not only talk to each other, but we'll have rooms, hangouts, where you'll be able to hang out and talk to peers and ask questions like, are you having an issue with this? Or what have you done with HD base T in this application? Or where has DVLED worked or not worked for you? And those will be regular people, the attendees talking to each other.
And I think that's one of the things that, people really want to get back to is live interaction. And that's another thing that makes our show special is it's not just a bunch of pre-recorded stuff. I mean, you're going to get to talk to the award-winning instructors like yourself and Jonathan Braun, Joe Cornwall, I mean, just Tom Kerr. I mean, people that have been in the industry for a long time, you're going to get real-time interaction with them, plus with the other attendees. And right now with us all maybe kind of being back to work, but some being quarantined and some distance learning, it's really the live, the personal touch that I think makes our show really special.
Yeah, and there hasn't been a single show this year, including our own, the ones that launched us, where we don't have some sessions pre-recorded. In your case, they're not. In your case, those educational sessions are all done live, which is quite unique. And the advantage of that is that when you're asking somebody a question, you know, using the Q&A, you actually are actually able to ask the person the actual question, and they'll hang out and answer the questions afterwards. You mentioned four of the instructors. You've got some new ones as well. You have Kay Sargent coming back, who's amazing. She's been at some of the E4 events before, but you also have Pete Coleman, who is kind of new to our segment of the industry. He's an Australian who I've worked with for 4 years at the Integrate show in Sydney and Melbourne, Australia. And he's moved here to the US and he's gonna make his US debut at E4 Evolution. You're gonna love him, Melody. I know you met him quickly, but not only does he have a cool accent and easy to listen to, but he's a systems designer. So he's got an architectural and AV design experience that is really unique. He did Mercedes headquarters in Australia with this really immersive LED system that he put together. People are gonna really love him. So you've got some great instructors, but you also have every major brand that does anything big time in our industry participating in the solution centers.
Yeah, absolutely. And just one more comment about the speakers. I think one thing that we've really carefully done is trying to bring in different voices into the curriculum. So you have Kay Sargent, who is with an interior design with HOK, one of the largest architecture firms in the world. You know, you have Pete, who's a systems designer. We have Gymnista, who's from the ad agency creative side of things for digital signage. And then, you know, you have people that are more technical, like Tom Kerr and Joe Cornwall. And then, of course, your two great sessions that you're bringing with, you know, forward-looking types of ideas. So it's a well-rounded event, I think, bringing in different perspectives and plus those of the major manufacturers. And we're excited to bring this subject matter insight series back to the solution centers because we really get to tap into the top talent at the manufacturer level and get some in-depth interviews with them about what's happening in the industry, what it means for their product line, what it means for the integrator. And we do four of those in each solution center. And of course that equals to one RU. To really getting access to some really incredible people within the platform.
Yeah, and it's interesting that you mentioned that because we go through and help you get the CTS approval. And we know that what you have to do is that education has to be technical. And if it's not, you only get a half of the credit. We get the full credit for it because we take the manufacturers that have the expertise, the technical people, and force them to talk about the technical issues and the application issues, not about the products. You're not going to get a product spiff. You're going to actually get a spiel. You're going to actually get technical information. And a lot of those people end up coming to the event and they'll be hanging out on networking, answering questions. One thing that happened to me this morning, I was actually talking to a guy who registered for your event this morning from Rochester Institute of Technology, RIT. He's getting ready to rebuild all of his classrooms. He's coming because he wants to listen to my Future of the Classroom session that I'm going to be doing. And as a point of fact, that's a great example where he'll be hanging out on networking. And I'm sure he'll be interested in having some integrators and manufacturers talk to him about some of the products and technology because he's sort of at the beginning of redoing all these classrooms. And so another element here is that you actually have the ability to talk to the individual people. So you'll have manufacturers obviously will be hanging out there and you'll recognize who they are by their names, but also integrators and end users. So you have a unique event. Most other distributor events don't have end users attending your event. And the reason why you do is the quality of education.
Yeah, and that's something that we have been working towards for many years with the live E4 events is getting those you know, key technology influencers there. And, you know, that's what gets our exhibitors really excited is like, wow, I've been wanting to get in front of University XYZ for a long time. And here they are at the show. I get to have a conversation with them. And, you know, and that's what we're doing here. And, you know, this is not a replacement for live events. This is a, this is a different way of delivering it. It's an augmentation and allowing us to get to different geographies and different folks. And the feedback that we got last year from our event was that it was one of the easiest, best interfaces with the best array of content and that they have seen in any virtual show. And that's basically a summation of many, many of the quotes that we got from our customers saying like, this is the best.
Well, I mean, your team deserves a lot of credit. You're using the Launch VTS platform to do it, but we couldn't have done it without the vision of some of your team members who kind of thought out the UI and UX of where people would likely want to go. Because most of these virtual systems that have a lot of content, like yours is not like a typical event where you go and all the content's linear. Your content's nonlinear in that you can go a lot of different places once you enter. Most of them use these fake booths. Layout, and you're guiding them based on application and products and technology and the people, not based on hey, come check out all the stuff we have in our booth. So I think you'll really love it. I'm sure most of the people who are watching this have heard of the E4 shows. Of course, the experience is the live show. The evolution is the virtual event we've been talking about. It's 9th, 10th, and 11th of March. You can register at e4evolution.com. I'm going to put a link in the description of this video cast as well, but definitely go register. Even if you think you're only going to go to one session or you just want to check out networking or you just want to check out who's online, go ahead and register, because if you do that, you'll be able to click one button and go straight into the site rather than having to go back through the registration. Because here's what's going to happen. You're going to hear about my session or Jonathan Braun's session on LinkedIn or on Twitter, and then you're going to be like, I'm going to go watch the other sessions. And now you got to take 2 or 3 minutes to register. So go ahead and register. Go ahead and do it. Get set up in the system, and then let's go from there. So e4evolution.com. I have one last question for you, Melody. Are we going to be able to bring back a live event this fall, you think? I mean, a lot of people have been talking about live events coming back this fall. What do you think? Will we be able to have an E4 event back live again?
I'm very hopeful. We have been working with a lot of our partners on a very comprehensive health and safety plan. I think it's doable because, you know, we are focused on a smaller regional event where we can, you know, have certain protocols in place. So I'm very hopeful. So we'll see.
I hope so, because I like you. I agree 100%. Virtual events are great, but they're not awesome, right? I mean, the awesomeness comes in the in-person events. But what you've done is created a bridge between great and awesome with the E4 evolution. This is as close, and I'm not saying it just because of the launch platform. Go check out the other events. Go look at the other events that other brands have put on, and then come to E4 evolution, and you will see a difference. We haven't gotten any feedback back that was like, this is a letdown, or this is just like everyone else's event. None of the comments come in like that. They come back, like Melody said, saying this is different than what they've seen before. So that's the key. I mean, that was the key behind the whole development of the E4 Evolution event. So go register now, e4evolution.com. Melody, thank you very much for joining me.
Thanks, Gary.
Y'all have a great day.
Today is your lucky day. It is Rants and Raves with Gary.